of how NTPC expects its financials to play out going into the rest of FY18. But let's shift our attention right now to some earnings that we've seen come through. 8K Miles has posted a steady quarter, steady set of numbers. Profit jump about 97% in the quarter gone by. To get more details, let's connect with Suresh Venkatachari. He's the chairman and CEO of 8K Miles. Suresh, good to have you on the show. My first question really, the June quarter looks like a green tick when it comes to revenue, profit, EBITDA growth. Margins, however, have decreased slightly. Just help us understand, the underlying reasons for this performance and also for the margin decline this time.
So we grew quarter on quarter 17%. Our EBITDA margin stays at around 33%, 32.9%. We used to do about 34% because we acquired a cornerstone in May 2017. And with the integration, there is a slight drop in EBITDA. And we would expect in the next maybe 2 to 3 quarters, we will grow our EBITDA by cross-selling and upselling our cloud solutions into the healthcare clients.
All right, Suresh, I want to get a sense of, your growth this time. If we exclude the inorganic growth, any acquisitions that you made over the last 12 months, how has organic growth looked this time?
This actually, if you see, the previous acquisition was only done in September 2015. And the recent acquisition is happened in May 2017. Approximately more than 18 months, we have grown organically. And we are growing both organically in our accounts, large accounts, the enterprise accounts, where we do the complete cloud transformation for the major life science accounts. We are also acquiring minimum 2 customers every quarter in the last, I would say, about 4 to 6 quarters. So we are going more on an organic basis, and the inorganic helps us to acquire additional clients where we can able to go and sell our cloud solutions, data analytics, and also our mobile and IoT and managed services.
All right, so then let's talk about the acquisitions then. If we talk about the Cornerstone acquisition, how has this helped you with new deals and revenue growth?
So Cornerstone, only a 2 month acquisition actually happened, May and June. It helps the traditional consulting revenue of implementing revenue of electronic health records and EMR was adding into the revenue. But however, we are now working on a multiple POC with the hospitals where we can able to host the cloud as a service for the EMR as a service, and also we are building a platform now which can able to host us for like a EMR for many hospitals as a common platform. That would we would expect probably in the next 2 to 3 quarters we would able to secure the bunch of clients where that would help us in more of a recurring revenue stream.
All right, so 2 to 3 quarters is the kind of time horizon we're looking at in terms of the revenue stream coming in there for Cornerstone. But Suresh, if you could also just take us through the kind of sectoral performance we've seen. What has been the revenue spread if we talk sectorally, and performance in terms of if we talk about sectors like media, healthcare, analytics and others?
So we generate more than 50% of our revenue in the healthcare and life sciences, which includes hospitals and large pharma companies. We continue to grow there, and also we added customers in the solution providers. Like we work with a major cloud providers, they are also generating revenue for us in security and identity space. We work with e-commerce and the media and also manufacturing retail. So those are all add up around the rest of the around 40% of our revenue. Our growth sector we identify is in the healthcare life sciences. In addition to that, financial services is the industry where we focus to build more sustainable revenue. As you know, 8K Miles is specialized in the cloud transformation for a highly regulated secure workloads, which requires a lot of data privacy, compliance and security like HIPAA or a GxP or a PCI, high trust kind of a thing, where we specialize our platform and our processes and the product. So that helps us to grow in a very niche market, where we could able to win a very large enterprise accounts against the major players.
Absolutely. So, Suresh Venkatachari, thank you so much for joining in, giving us really the road ahead there for 8K Miles. That's the chairman and CEO of 8K Miles, came out with their earnings just a short while ago. But let's talk about liquor stocks, because they really are in high spirits. This as the Supreme Court eases the ban on selling liquor near highways. Pincon Spirits is up about 9% or 10% now in trade today. We spoke to the management of the company earlier today to really understand the impact of this ruling on the liquor business. Listen in.
think that the growth should be in terms of